Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video I'm doing my Bali haul. So I'm basically just going to show you what I bought in Bali because everything's so cheap there, and I did buy a few things I wanted to share and like how much I spent and like how much you should only spend on things, because it was a bit confusing at the start, as I will tell you. But I hope you enjoy this video. It won't go too long, so just sit back and relax. So to start off with sort of like the boring things and the problem that I ran into, the first thing I did buy was these Bing Tang shirts. So when we first went to the markets, like my boyfriend almost bought a shirt for $95 Australian, and instead of him buying something, I was like, I'll buy something, because they wouldn't let us leave the store. Like, they were like, no, no, like, we need money. Like, basically, that's what they're saying. And so I was like, fine, I'll get something. Like, get me a size in this. I wanted to get pink, but they didn't have my size. I wanted a medium. It is still, I could have gotten a small, but I didn't really know how it would fit or anything, so I just got a medium. So I got purple instead, and they were like, they at first wanted like $50 Australian, but then I got it down to 35, and at the time I didn't think it like transferred into $35 Australian. So I spent $35 on this Bing Tang singlet that should have only been $5. So basically with all of our shirts over there, you don't want to spend any more than $5 because it's just not worth it at all. I bought this Adidas t-shirt. It's like got, I don't know if you can see the pattern, but it's like a bit like that sort of, it's got like little sort of stripey on it, if that makes sense. But this is also really comfy, and it's like, the sign is legit like actually the same as Adidas. So, you know, why not? I don't mind buying fake stuff, to be honest. And then I bought a Nike one. And then I bought these cute little pouches. So I got a fake Michael Kors one in brown, but it comes with a little strap that you can clip on the side here. So I can do it like this. You know, just take it out clubbing, I reckon. And it does have a little zip inside as well. So I really like this one. And like, even though it's like fake, it still feels pretty nice. And like, the logo is pretty spot on. And I got this other one that I like adore with my whole life. And it's like this one. It's like got flowery patterns, and I just, for some reason, like just die over this. I've always wanted one like this because I feel like it's such a good accessory piece if you just wear something that's like black, most likely. And the strap is on here, but you can't take it off, but that does not worry me because I actually like the strap. Like, if I go out, I put my hand through it and just hold it like that, so it's like double security. Can't get over it, to be honest. I can't stop saying "to be honest" in this video. I don't normally say it. I don't know why I'm saying it. I bought from the same shop, and I got them for $15 together. You can literally get them down to $5, but this girl was not budging, and I couldn't leave this. I legit couldn't. She initially wanted 50 for both, and I was like, get out, come on, seriously. And it's just so funny because they also, if you buy a shirt, right, and it's a different, like, if you buy two shirts and one size is bigger than the other, they like just think it costs more because one's like shirt is a bigger size. And it's like, and also they say if the color's different, then it's extra as well. And they're all just saying that so you actually give them the money, but just don't fall for it. Just say no and then walk away. Like, I know this is what everyone says, but it actually works. You actually just say no, walk away, and they're like, fine. They say like, fine, just give me whatever you want. And then I bought this Marc Jacobs watch. Can you see that? It's gold with like sort of a champagne gold face in the middle. Got the little bling around the outside. Ow! And it cost $25 and it was free for them to take links off if it's too big, so that was like really good. And you can buy what, like this was actually in a shopping mall, like with one of those little pop-up stand things. You can go to the market and buy watches, which are like $5 to $10. But when you pick it up, it legit feels like a feather. Like you can just tell it's not good quality at all. And I just didn't want to buy something that, like, even though this one's not like real, it just like had like that more weight, and I knew that it was better quality. And then I bought these. I don't even know what brand these are because it has a little, I just don't know what brand these are, to be honest. I bought earrings, and this is from one of these watches shops. Like if you go there, you'll see them everywhere. I'm pretty sure it's like Euro watches or something. They're like legit everywhere. So I bought these, and they are so cute. You can get them in gold or rose gold, and I obviously got rose gold. And what you can do is you can unscrew this rose gold part off and then change the diamond. Like, so in there right now it's like a clear crystal one, but it comes with red, purple, and like sort of like a champagne sort of stone. So I just thought that was super cool. I was like, I've never seen this before ever, and they only cost me $12, and I was like, hell yeah, buddy. And then just from the markets, I just bought this little keyring. Oh, is it? Yeah, keyring. Yeah. I don't know what I thought it was, but I got a little pink one. It has a little elephant and like gold hardware. Oh, I did get my sister's and my mum one, and I just thought that was so cute. Oh, I got that for like $2. So, one shop wanted I think about $10 each, and I was like, every time they say those prices to me, I like get really, like I was getting angry most of the time because I was just like, can you stop this? Like, I know what I'm doing, so don't try make me spend more money than I should. And they always ask you when they first greet you, where are you from and how many times have you come to Bali? Because if you say you've come to Bali like once, they will legit try to get so much money out of you because they would just know you have no idea what you're doing. I also just got this little, one of those little bracelets that you buy when you go over there. I just thought this was a little cute little dainty one. And I did buy my two best friends one as well because I'm so nice. And then these are like one of my last three favorite things as well. So most of you would know the brand Burberry, and for ages and ages and ages I've wanted one of their scarves, like legit for ages, and I'd always search on eBay for them, but they wouldn't make the cut because I don't like the silk versions of the one I wanted, and most of them on eBay were the silk version, and then if I did find a non-silk version, the pattern on it wasn't right and the colour wasn't right, and it had like, it just wouldn't be right, and I didn't want to spend money on something that I didn't like. But then when I went into the shops where I bought the watch, they had my scarf. So this is it. I just love it, and the material feels so good. Oh, and it does have the Burberry label, which the ones on eBay have like Australian, some weird label, and it comes with like probably like a little fake Burberry tag. But this feels so soft, I can't even deal with it. And they put it in a Burberry sort of bag, which I'm gonna keep it in until I wear it, and then when I do take it off, I'm gonna put it back in there. Gotta keep it clean. But yeah, I just adore this scarf, and I wanted it for so long. I bought it there for $30, which on eBay I found them for like $20, and I was just like, this is a bargain. And then I bought Nike shoes. I got this color, because I don't actually have black Nikes. I only have plain white Kmart ones, and then pink Nikes, and then gray Nikes with a pink on it. So I don't really have black at all, and I really wanted black, so I got black. I was initially going to get the black bottom ones and with the white tick, I think it was, but I felt like I looked like a boy in it, so I got the white, and I'm really happy I did get the white. And then I ended up getting these ones for $25, which I find really good, $25 for a pair of Nikes. And then I got some Adidas, and this, my Nikes and my Adidas were like number one things I wanted to buy. The rest were just sort of like, oh, I like that, and bought it. These are like the things I wanted to get. I got these ones for $30 from the same shop, and apparently since they're Adidas, they are more expensive. But I don't mind paying an extra $5. Like, I was like, I want them, I need them, I'm paying another $5 for them. And these ones feel like really good quality. Like, they're really thick, they're really hard. Nothing really about them looks fake. Probably the shoelaces, but the place I went to get these, like if you go to Bali and you want to try find Nikes in Adidas, and I bought my Nike shirt from them as well. So this place was across from this, oh, it was next to this Italian restaurant, which is near, so there's a place called Kuta Square. And if you go to Kuta Square, go to where, at the end where KFC is, and then turn right. I didn't know which one was left and right then. You turn right and keep walking down, you'll see this Italian restaurant with like a red sort of like roof thing. Those, like, yeah, it's just red. You'll see it. And then next to that is the shop. And you'll know it. It has like a whole wall full of Nikes and Adidas along the side. I could have done more shopping, like I would have loved to buy more things, but I did do a lot of adventuring things, which did cost money as well. And I did get another $150 out to just do shopping. So the rest I did just spend on adventuring and food, because you basically have to buy food every day. Because there's no supermarket, so you can't go there and like cook your own food. You have to just buy food like whenever you want it, but you just have to buy it. So next time I go, I'm probably gonna choose between if I want to adventure and shop, and I think I'm gonna do the shopping since I have done most of the adventuring. Because all the adventures that I did sort of cost money to get into the place. So if I adventure next time, I'll just go to like all the beaches and all those free beautiful places and just shop my heart out. I really want to like go next year because I just love it so much, and it's just like the best place on earth, I think. So since I stayed in a villa, it did cost more than a hotel room, and so I think the next time I go, I'm just gonna go to a hotel room so it's cheaper again. And I went to the villa because I went with my boyfriend, so we just wanted like our own sort of area. But yeah, I really did enjoy it. I don't regret anything. It was like the best thing of my life, and that was the first time I've traveled overseas, so it was even better. And I just missed the whole experience, but it's just amazing, to be honest. And there, I said it again. I think I should go now. So thank you guys for watching this haul. I really do love the products I bought, and and I didn't buy any makeup because I legit don't have any makeup there, because it's just not a thing. Otherwise I would have bought heaps of makeup. Anyway, besides that, goodbye, and thank you so much for watching.